Idan Levin, put a little applause.
Hello, thank you for coming. I appreciate it in the weather. Can you hear me? Back there, it's okay?
Yeah.
Yeah? Great, thank you.
Maybe louder a little bit.
Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Right.
Fine, thanks.
Okay. Serious question. Angular or to react? Poyer is really occupied by this manner and really this what he came to find, if to use Angular or to use React. Is there somebody in the audience that come to answer this question? Nobody? Just, okay. Is somebody already decided you want to do React or you want to do Angular? React people? Angular people? Maybe Vue people?
Oh,
there is one. It will be more of you, don't worry. Okay, so let's do a brief introduction. My name is Idan Levin. I'm software engineer for about 15 years. I worked in a lot in various fields like embedded, desktop, mobile, and web server, and recently also client. One very important thing. Right now I'm working at OM2. OM2, it's very exciting place to be. You can ask the guys back there, the Reactive Pandas team, that around, say who? They're a little bit tired, they're in the middle of hackathon. So OM2, it's a company that specializes in building a platform for fintech, B2B company, and it's very exciting place to be because it's kind of an innovation hub, meaning that the company is a company group and it's specialized on taking ventures and creating successful companies, not a strategy to exit or to do stock produce, but to create really successful company that lasts long time. So, in the end of 2016, we asked ourselves to Angular or to React. So this is our story. So we come to replace the old dinosaur, the previous product that we have. The product was running in production, very successful product with a lot of traffic, a product that exists for about 6 years in this time. And we know that there is like a huge team that support it. And we know some problems. Basically, this is the problem, that you start, everything is simple, everything is shiny, and you can just develop like the wind, everything okay, and then the business start to ask more thing, complexity rises, and stuff become heavier, we put more and more developer, and eventually, this is what it looks like, it's a monster, nobody, 20 people can push it, and we began to stuck. So, how we can fix this problem? There is a very old practice that existed for the last 20 years, and basically it's microservices. We'll know a little bit about microservices. Is there a full stack developer here? Very little. Somebody did previously maybe web or backend, straight to the front end and that's it? Okay. Is there a person in the audience that worked on the same project for more than 1 year? Okay, so you will get to the problem, you will get to the complexity and the fact that you wish that you never chose any framework and I don't know, become an electronical engineer or something else. You will get to there. Don't worry, continue to work on the project and you will see it. So actually we don't have a lot of time to talk about microservices. It's something really, really complex with a lot of theory and a lot of different approaches. But I recommend to each and everyone to start reading about microservices. It's not a backend thing. It's general topic that help you become better engineer. And this is in the end what you want to be. Better engineer to produce better things. The idea of microservices, it's basically in high level. It's around splitting the monolith to vertical around the business boundaries, around the business capabilities. So the idea that we don't have database team, front-end team, back-end team, and all working on some huge elephant, but we have something like authentication, shopping cart, and things around the business domain itself. The practice is really, really old in the back-end, but only recently we had a new term that called micro frontends. Is somebody heard about micro frontends? Okay, it's the same people. So micro frontends extend this practice from the backend to the frontend. And eventually we can create a team that oriented on business capabilities and break the big complex thing that we build to a smaller things around the same context and the business abilities. So we knew most of it ahead of time before we start to develop, and we designed really, really hard our system. I can say that we chose React because in this time Angular 2 was relatively new and still really, really heavy, and we have concern about performance and bundling side. So we chose React. And I can say personally, I didn't really mind it if to use React, Angular, or anything else. But I wanted this time, I know that I want to use something like Flux model and not to use MVC. MVC doesn't work on the client, it's something that failed. So the data model, this is what I cared about it in this time. But the next thing that I saw, it's this. Dependency L. Models start to talk with another model, micro frontend, talking with another micro frontend, and basically a complete mess, dependency L. And we work really, really, really hard to design the interface to think what interact with what. So when I retrospect about it, why it's happened, the first reason, Redux, it's too easy. So it's like database on the backend. Some developer have problem. Don't worry about it. I just stick it in the Redux store and everything will be all right. We're just going to override the problem, go around it and make another link that nobody see, nobody manage. And basically this is the second problem. Even if you use types, we don't have any easy way to manage all of this mess. So, another thing that we saw, basically, we are trained because of the history of the fields. When we think about front-end, we train to think with our eyes and see what visually we have on the page and component use. So, this is a bad habit because of our history, basically to do the view side of the backend. And even if you try to do it other ways, you will see that this is what you fall back to because this is what you used to do. What we want to do instead, before that. So I want to quote Norbert from Storybook. I guess that all of you know Storybook, right? Okay. He said, components should abstract UI pattern or concept. This is very different from a section of visual UI. Meaning, you have a tabs, you have sliders, some complex UI, put it in components, reuse it, share it, it's something that will help you. Another thing, you have a look and feel for your company, for your brand. work building components and share the style and reuse it. But when you start to take application and use visual section like a mini application, basically what you're doing is to model your system by the view. You need to practice a little bit server-side rendering web, and you will know that it's the worst thing that you can do. Modelize all the system by the view. This is what you're doing when you're using a component for visual UI section. So, this is what we want to do. Is to take all the application and all the functionality and the stuff that we see and the stuff we don't see, especially the stuff that we don't see, because it's going to last much longer and it's much more important. The view keep changing, add me a button, paint me, delete me, and etc. etc. So the part that you don't want, don't see, and basically put it in the right micro frontend or microservice around the business capability. So after we complete our micro frontend, this is what we see. We can have internals of the micro frontends like network, data, business logic, utilities. We can still have one framework or library or other like React or Angular. We can decouple the components from the rest of the world, just use web component, and we'll be able to just interact with the DOM very simply without missing any other micro frontend. But then you reach the other problem, that we're building one system. We're not building a collection of mini applications, meaning that no matter how much we design our system, things are going to interact with one another. So how we can manage this interaction? Basically, public API, meaning that we want to keep our internal to ourselves, not allowing anyone to touch this internal and publish our API. And this is the only thing that any other party will interact with us. So how we can accomplish it? How we can communicate? This is the part that I'm feeling like I'm selling ice to the Eskimos. I'm going to sell you guys service. So service is a little bit misunderstood when we're talking about front end. Usually when I say this word, you're going to think that I'm talking about connection to backend or some kind of proxy. No, I'm talking about a regular plain old service. Like you know, for example, from Angular, meaning that I'm loosely coupled. A module, it's something that tightly coupled, meaning that I'm sharing reference. And service, meaning that I loosely coupled, I just know some information about the interface, and this is enough for me to talk with the service. But we have a problem, we don't know if Angular is going to destroy version 3. We don't know if tomorrow nobody wants to do Angular, maybe somebody wants to do React, and we stay without any developer. We don't want to commit to one thing. So this is why we need to find another solution for how to create our service. What Angular do we want, or which kind of framework or library? If you want to use common JS module or ESX module, we have this complete freedom about what to do. We can do A/B testing, meaning to create two services for the same API, and do A/B testing to see if this works better or this works better, and just throw away the one that works less and try a new test. So we can do this without doing any build, without doing any release. We can do, each team can just do it, and this is about it. We can use the same mechanism to do canary release, meaning to register a new service, to assign it only to a certain group of users, and if everything is okay, continue to production, and if not, just roll back the release. And this without changing any of the consumer, even not one line. Testing. We're going to simply test our API. API is taking for a long time. We're not going to refactor it each time that we change our store, our view, just when we add some new feature. And if we were going to refactor, it's very easy. We got the test already written. We're free to focus on the code itself, to write better code, cleaner code, or whatever that is interesting for us. Collaboration. Now our team know exactly what they're doing, what each other doing, and it's very easy to start with simply mock of the contract that we agreed upon. And one more thing, we right now can go out from the main thread. You know that everything that we do in our main thread, it's going to block our rendering, our network, and basically it's one process. So we simply can create a service, move it to WebWorker or IFM for security, and we don't have to plan it, we don't have to think about it, just move it, you're going to find the services, or even if you want to do some crazy application that will create new tabs and communicate between these new tabs, it will be as easy as using a local object. So, to Angular or to React? React? Okay, you want to hear my answer? I guess no, so thank you. So, actually, I say neither or both. It's no longer such a big deal. There is no risk. Right now, if Angular is not popular anymore, we're just going to start our new micro frontend with React and go on. React starting to be annoying. We can start doing Vue. There is no risk anymore. So, the world is good again. We don't have to wonder about this problem anymore. We're free to learn micro frontends, to learn BDD, TDD, and reactive programming, whatever that's interesting for us, it's no longer a live or die question. So, everything that we do is open source. We have ScaleCube that I mentioned, and we have Capsula.js, that it's basically an organization, open source organization, that dedicate to make micro frontends more accessible with finding a framework like single SPA or tooling or methodology and group it all in one comfortable location. And of course, what I explained here, ScaleCube, it's all open source. You are welcome to try, join, give feedback. It's free, open source. We would like you to try it. Thank you.